Hi there and welcome back. Let's review coarctation of the aorta. We'll look into the law of large numbers, what we know as we speak, symptoms, diagnosis, treatment, complications, and how do we underwrite. Coarctation of the aorta is congenital focal narrowing of the thoracic aorta, usually distal to the left subclavian artery. Simply speaking, a narrowing of the large blood vessel or aorta that leads from the heart. Statistically speaking, fewer than 200,000 US cases per year. About 30 to 60% have coexisting bicuspid aortic wall that we have discussed previously in one of the prior sessions. Male to female ratio is about more than 2 to 1, and one study suggests it accounts for 7% of all congenital heart defects. There is increased mortality even 30 years after the treatment due to restenosis, development of aortic aneurysm or dissection, and development of aortic wall disease, as well as persistent hypertension. Another study suggests best prognosis if surgery or angioplasty was performed in childhood and there is no residual hypertension. What are the signs and symptoms? Clinically recognized by hypertension in the arms above the obstruction with lower blood pressure in the legs. Aortic stenosis, intracranial aneurysms, PDA or patent ductus arteriosus, ventricular septal defects, faint or unobtainable pulses in the lower extremities are the typical symptoms. How do we diagnose? Diagnosis is based on clinical findings and is confirmed by Doppler echocardiography. Blood pressure in upper extremities more than 10 mmHg, higher than lower extremities. MRI and Doppler echo helps to identify associated cardiac defects as well as the site and severity of coarctation. Treatment consists of procedures that involve surgery or a catheter-based procedure to fix the narrowing. The team of cardiologist, vascular surgeon and cardiothoracic surgeon working together decides what is the best course of action to be taken. It may be angioplasty, that is unblocking an artery by inflating a balloon inside it. A stent may be inserted to hold the artery open. Sometimes cardiac cath may be used, and that is inserting a long tube into the groin, neck or arm and then threading it through the blood vessels to the heart. Aggressive treatment for hypertension is another option to consider. Current guidelines recommend surgical or non-surgical repair. Once peak gradients more than 20 mmHg are discovered. What are the complications? It includes endocarditis, sudden cardiac death, aortic rupture, congestive heart failure, intracranial hemorrhage, recurrence of coarctation, coronary artery disease despite successful surgical correction, and persistent hypertension. So how do we underwrite? As far as underwriting goes, follow your underwriting manual and company specifics and take that route. Let's take a quick break here and see you soon. Take care. Bye now.